On this super review, let's take a look at the KZ ZS10 Pro. Just when I thought I was getting bored of KZ, they actually kind of surprised me with the ZSN Pro. This is a ZS10 Pro, don't get that confused, with the ZSN Pro, which I reviewed recently, and I actually found that KZ had made a pretty significant improvement in just the general tonality of the sound. And frankly, that kind of surprised me. So here they've got the ZS10 Pro, which is a step above. I think this is around a $50 earphone versus the $20-ish ZSN. And man, all these names are really confusing. But what I can tell you about this thing is that, like its predecessor, it is a 10 driver headphone, or that's to say there's 5 drivers per ear. You got 1 dynamic driver and 4 balanced armature drivers just inside each ear, making a lot of noise. And that's actually a pretty common driver configuration for KZ. In fact, just within the last 6 months, KZ has released the ZS7 and the CCA C10, which have the exact same driver configuration. Is there anything that's actually different about these earphones? Let's go ahead and open up the ZS10 Pro and find out. All right, I've been listening to the KZ ZS10 Pro for about the past week now, and like we talked about before, this is not KZ's first 10 driver earphone. In fact, there have been 3 of them in the last 6 months, so I've been spending some time comparing these things directly to those other 10 driver KZs, including the CCA C10 and the KZ ZS7. I also did compare these to the original KZ ZS10 just to kind of see how far these guys have come in the last year or so. And before we get into talking about the sound, let's start by talking about the build of this earphone. If you're familiar with the build of the KZ ZSN or the ZSN Pro or even the CCA C10, you're gonna be very familiar with the build of this earphone because it's basically exactly the same. The shells are the exact same shape. It's a clear plastic, it's pretty handsome looking. And then on the outside, you've got a metal panel, and all these earphones kind of have their own unique version of this metal panel on the outside. And I gotta say, I think the ZS10 Pro is kind of the coolest looking just because it's got this, you know, chrome plating. It's nice and shiny. It is a little bit of a fingerprint magnet, but I think it looks pretty good. In terms of fit, these things fit pretty well. And this is true of all of the KZ earphones that I just described. They fit pretty comfortably. It's a little bit bulky, but not uncomfortable at all. In terms of isolation, I think they also do a pretty solid job. So generally, I'm pretty happy with the build of these buds. One thing that's worth calling out though is this cable you see, you might notice, is not actually the cable that came with the KZ ZS10 Pro, but it's similar to the cable that should have come with it. I don't know, if you saw during the unboxing, my ZS10 Pro actually shipped with a very old style KZ cable, which is, it's abysmal. I mean, abysmal is definitely overstating it. It's just a cable that I don't want to deal with anymore. It's got memory wires and it's really super fiddly and gets tangled up all the time. It's a bad cable. And KZ hasn't been shipping headphones with that cable for a while. In fact, if you look at the pictures of the ZS10 Pro, it's got a cable that looks a lot more like this, which is a pretty nice cable. For some reason, mine shipped with that old style cable. I think it's a mistake, but that's just something to watch out for. If you order a pair of these earphones and you get a cable that's got memory wires on it, I would ask for a return. So now let's go ahead and talk about the sound of the KZ ZS10 Pro. And just to kind of set the stage, the general sound signature that this thing is going for, I would say is just kind of like a mainstream balanced sound, which is not to say neutral, just to be clear, don't confuse balanced for neutral. What I mean by balance is that there's a nice emphasis in the bass region, which a lot of people like. The lower mid-range has got a little bit of a dip, and then the upper mid-range, you get a little bit of a rise. And what that tends to do is it makes it sound very clean. It doesn't sound like full or muddy at all because you've got that lower mid-range dip. And then the upper mid-range rise can bring out a little bit of vocal emphasis, which I think most people like. And through that section of the sound signature, I think this is actually doing a really solid job. The bass has got just a really, really nice emphasis on it that is, I think, very tasteful. It's not overdone at all. The bass never really feels boomy. Like, it feels surprisingly tight, punchy, as you want bass to sound. The mid-range is generally pretty clean. Frankly, not a lot to speak of there. Except that I'm pretty happy with the general tuning of the mid-range. And then we get to the treble region, which is where there's some things to like here, but there also might be some things that could be a problem for you depending on your personal preferences. So generally, look, the treble is a little bit elevated and extended. It does actually make this earphone, at least comparison to something like the KZ ZS10 Pro, it gives it a little bit more, I don't know, sense of space, a little bit more sense of, you know, detail, perception, that kind of stuff. That's what you get with a little bit of extra treble in it. And I think that you definitely get it here with the ZS10 Pro. The one downside is that there's a spike somewhere in that treble that is, at least for my ears, kind of landing right on the sibilance region. And so certain songs, like, for example, I've got a song by The Cure called Pictures of You, and there's just a section of it where the dude's vocals are just hitting S's and T sounds, and it is a little bit brutal on this earphone, frankly. And I'll be fair, that section of that song can be brutal on a lot of different earphones, including a lot that I really like to listen to. But that is definitely something to keep in mind with the ZS10 Pro, is that there is that bit of emphasis in the treble that can have that effect on sibilance. Now, to start the comparisons of this earphone to some of the others, I started by comparing this thing directly to the original KZ ZS10, which came out, I think, about a year ago. And there's really not much comparison. If you're cross-shopping these, I would just forget about the ZS10 at this point. I mean, the one big difference just off the bat is the build quality and the fit. KZ has definitely gotten that a lot better here with the ZS10 Pro. But then also, even in the sound, I think sound signature wise, like, kind of what they were going for with the ZS10 is similar to what they're going for here. But, you know, at KZ's, I don't know, they had a little bit of kind of funky tonality with their earphones about a year ago. And I think that the ZS10 Pro does away with that. And we kind of got the same result with the KZ ZSN, where KZ's just kind of, they're dialing in that tonality, and it's getting to a point where it doesn't sound funky really at all. I think it sounds nice and clean here, especially compared to something like the ZS10. And now to compare this thing to something a little bit more modern, we've got the KZ ZS7, which has got quite a bit different build. And frankly, for my ears, I prefer the fit of the ZS10 Pro. When it comes to the sound signatures, they're actually quite a bit different. I would say that the ZS7 definitely has a lot more sub bass. And if that's what you want, if you just want a ton of some sub bass rumble, you might actually prefer the ZS7. For me, I find it really just kind of overwhelming. It doesn't feel like it's done especially tastefully, whereas here, the bass emphasis is just about what I want. Other big difference is that actually the ZS7, so I mentioned that the treble here is a little bit sharp and can be a little bit sibilant, but I think that the treble on the ZS7 is even a little bit hotter. There's also a little bit more emphasis on the vocal range here, sort of like in the upper mid range, which makes vocals, at least to my ear, sound a lot more clear, more forward, and a lot more part of the mix rather than, well, a lot more separate, honestly, which is kind of what I like, versus with the ZS7, there's not quite that same emphasis in the upper mid-range. So vocals just, they feel like they're swimming a little bit, especially because of that massive sub bass. The vocals are just kind of swimming in a soup of sound. So between this and the ZS7, there's really no question for me. I prefer the ZS10 Pro. And then comparing these things directly to the CCA C10, these things are actually more similar to the C10 than they are to the ZS7, even though the brand names are different, they are actually still KZ headphones. And to that point, the shells of this and the CCA, exactly the same. So fit-wise, very similar. Sound-wise, they are a little bit different though. I would say that the CCA C10, it's got a little bit more funkiness in the tonality. It sounds maybe, I guess you could describe it as a little bit muddy. It's not like super muddy, but it is a little bit muddy, especially compared to these. And I think that impression probably comes from a little bit less emphasis in the upper mid-range than what you get here with the ZS10 Pro. The one benefit I would throw to the C10 is that the treble doesn't seem quite as sharp as it does here on the ZS10 Pro. So you don't have quite the issues with sibilance on the C10, but that, you know, extra little bit of treble does, I think, improve the imaging on the ZS10 Pro. So which one is better there? I think I would still pick the ZS10 Pro just because personally I can deal with a little bit too much treble, and I prefer the tonality here versus the C10. So out of 5 stars, I'm gonna have to give the KZ ZS10 Pro a very solid 4 stars. I think just in terms of build quality, as long as you get the right cable, they're doing quite a lot right here. And that actually, you know, it kind of goes to show just how good the build is on the much cheaper KZ ZS10 Pro, that this basically has the same build and at $50 is still, I think, a very well built headphone. The sound tuning on this is surprisingly good. I think that KZ is definitely getting their tonality to feel just a lot more natural and less funky. You get a nice presence of bass, you get a nice little emphasis there without it feeling overwhelming like what I felt you got on the KZ ZS7. And then you get that little upper mid-range lift for vocal presence that I like. The only issue here is, you know, some people are gonna have an issue with the treble, and for me, it's not a big deal. It does mean that certain tracks that are especially sibilant, I might steer away from those tracks while listening on this earphone, but generally, I really quite like this headphone, the way it sounds, the way it feels, kind of everything about it. If you're interested in checking out the KZ ZS10 Pro, I do have links in the description down below. I gotta find a way to make that not rhyme. But anyway, while you're down there, you can hit the like button for the video if you liked it, you can subscribe to the channel, and then I'll see you on the next Super Review.